My name is Patrick. This specific video is regarding how to score 100 percentile in quant section, specifically in a 2-hour CAT paper. So my name is Patrick, scored 100 percentile in quant multiple times. In CAT 20, I scored a 99.98 percentile in the quant section. So my score in the slot 3 of the paper was 71 out of 78. It was scaled to 66.66. That is how the paper was. So considering this, if I want to score 100 percentile in quant, technically I should have a scale score of 70 plus. Now since we can't predict the difficulty level of the paper, let's look at generally how to score a 70 plus in the quant section. So ideally solve all the questions and maybe get one or two wrong, or maybe try to focus on accuracy and try to get that 20, 21, whatever questions correct as far as possible. 24 questions correct to get a so 26 questions in 40 minutes is approximately 1.5 minutes per question. So that means I need to solve all questions in a time of 1.5 minute per question on an average, okay, with an average accuracy of more than 93%. That is how you need to solve the quant paper. Now you need not solve all the questions in 1.5 minutes. So there will be some questions where you will solve really fast, so maybe 30-40 seconds per question. There will be some questions where you may take time. There will be tougher questions, so where you take 2 to 2.5 minutes. The key is to balance it off and average it to 1.5 minutes per question. Right? So that means you should be able to solve the easy questions in 30 to 40 seconds. Okay, and maybe the tougher ones in 2 minutes. That's how you need to try to work on your time as far as possible. So let's try to understand when I'm talking of 30 to 40 seconds, what does it mean? So let's take an example from CAT 20. So contractor agreed to construct a 6-kilometer road in 200 days. He employed 140 person for the work. After 60 days, he realized that 1.5 kilometer road had been completed. So that means 140 persons and 60 days. Now 60 days are complete, so how many more days are left? 140 days. So 140 persons can complete the particular work in 60 days. So in 140 days, 60 persons can complete the same work. Okay, I repeat. If 140 persons can complete the work in 60 days. So 140 into 60 man days. So in 140 days, which you want to complete, 140 is 200 minus 60. 140. In 140 days, if you want to complete, you will require 60 people, right? Because man days has to be equal. Also, here he completed 1.5 kilometer work. Here he has to complete 4.5 kilometer work, which is 3 times. That means number of people required also will be 3 times. So he will require 180 persons. Number of people required also will be 3 times. So he already has 140 persons. We want how many additional people? So we require 40 more people to complete the work. So 40 is the answer. So what I'm trying to tell you is, I can do this in my mind all the sum without writing it out. 140 people, maybe I'll write down a little bit, but not too much. The more you write, you waste your time. So 140 persons, 60 days. So automatically I get 140 days, so 60 persons. Also I see the work done is 3 times. So I multiply the persons into 3, becomes 180 persons. So how many additional people? 140 people I already have, 40 more people required, that will be the answer. 40 seconds I'll get able to answer the question, right? The key is not to form equations, not to put formulas. It takes time and it becomes slow. The less you write, the more you do in your mind, it's fine. I'm not saying don't write, you write. But try to work on techniques that will help you be faster. Okay, let's take one more question. Dick is twice as old as Tom and Harry is twice as old as Dick. So if I take Tom is the minimum, so Tom has 1, Dick is 3, and Harry will be twice 6. Dick's age is 1 year less than average of all the 3. Average of all the 3 is 3.33. So how much is Dick less? 0.33 less. But I want 1 year less. To make it 1 year less, I have to multiply by 3. So Harry's age also will be multiplied by 3. Will become 18, cross multiplication. So I get 18 straight away. Not from equation, just substituted values. So good at substituting values. Simple technique that will help you be fast. and should help you save time. Tom 1, so Dick 3, Harry 6, average 3.33. So as compared to Dick, it is 0.33 less, but I want 1 year less. Three times. So that means even Harry's age will become three times, will become 80. So learn the simple tricks. It's not difficult sum that you solve that will help you get 100 percentile. It's that simple techniques that will help you get 100 percentile. Or not even 100 percentile, but it will help you crack the examination. A lot of people focus on difficult sums. A lot of people focus on getting difficult techniques. It's not that. It's the simple techniques that help you to crack the exam. And that is what you need to learn. Strategy to score 100 percentile. You can solve 21-22 questions in 30 minutes. It again goes in two rounds. It's not that when you solve a paper, you get all the questions immediately. No, there will be some questions you may not get the answers to. Skip that. Don't try to waste your time on that. So that means in first 30 minutes, you may go to first round and solve 21-22 questions. You may leave around 4-5 questions. And you can solve the remaining 4-5 questions in last 10 minutes. Go back to those questions and maybe solve those. So that's how you solve. So first round could be 21-22, could be 23-24, could be anything. I'm just saying that two rounds. Try to complete first round in 30 odd minutes and then go back to second round, whatever sums you have missed. Ensure that you don't waste time on difficult sums. That's one common mistake people do when they try to, you know, target 100 percentile. They want to solve all questions, they waste time on difficult questions, and forget getting 100 percentile. Don't even score good marks in the exam because they've wasted time on tough questions. Remember, the basic fundamentals always apply to whatever strategy you use. Right? Don't get stuck, as I said in the first round. Also, try to find out methods to solve questions 1.5 minutes per question. So whenever you practice, keep trying to find better methods. That is what will help you to be good and fast. Traditional methods will not help you. So move out of the traditional methods, that equation formation, etc. That will not help you to get 100%. Try to move out and try to find faster ways of solving. The methods is what is going to help you crack the exam. Thank you.